Now let's move on to the right side of the V, verification and validation. As you recall, the bottom of the V is implementation, which puts out the source code. What you do next is unit test. Unit test involves testing individual subroutines, procedures, modules, small chunks of code, and because it's a small chunk of code, it's possible to test it very thoroughly and make sure every statement, every branch gets executed and tested, which is something that's generally impractical to do at higher levels of integration. When you've thoroughly shaken down the modules, you move on to integration test. Now, because you've already covered all the code in the unit test, the point of integration test is not to do that again. Rather, integration test asks the question, do all the pieces work together? So unit test said, does each piece work? And integration test says, do the pieces in general work together as pairs and triples and clusters of modules? Integration test traces to the high-level design, which is also about do the pieces work together. Beyond that is software test. Software test traces to the software requirement spec. All right, we know the pieces work. We know they work together, but does it actually do what it's supposed to do? And that answers the question, did the engineers build the software they wanted to build? Beyond that is the acceptance test. That traces to the product requirement spec. So the software test is an engineering test. Does the software do what we wanted it to do? The acceptance test tells you whether the customers are happy with what it did. The engineers might have built something and it works perfectly, but it's not what the customers wanted. Or the customers might have a way of using it that the engineers didn't really think about. And so that's what the acceptance test is about, is making sure the customers will be happy with the output. Now, there's some other activities generally associated with V&V that aren't explicit boxes in the V. One is software quality assurance, which is, did you actually follow the steps? Did you follow the process? Or did you skip steps? Or do you have systematic quality problems? Another one is peer reviews, because every work product is supposed to get peer reviewed, so that's sort of implicit in all the arrows. And the last one you hear about is regression test. Regression test is a specific type of testing, typically at the system level, but can be used elsewhere, where you're looking to say, well, we fixed a bug. Did it stay fixed, or did it come back to life after we made another change? So regression testing is a particular type of testing technique used within the context of the V. It'll show up in the test boxes.